So, we've already connected our file to Tableau. Now, in this lesson, we'll be creating our first sheet. It's really easy to do and resembles how we create a sheet in Excel or pretty much every other spreadsheet software. All I have to do is click here, and a new sheet will be created. Right. This is what a Tableau sheet looks like. We can have as many of them as we want. I can simply click on this little icon at the bottom, and a new worksheet is added. The other two icons, which are next to it, are for creating a new dashboard and a new story. We'll deal with dashboards further in the course, so we won't use these buttons for now. Okay, let's give some structure to what you are seeing here. If this software is new to you, things can be a bit confusing. So it will be best if we spend a few minutes, the remainder of this lesson, talking you through Tableau's interface. First off, we have 10 different tabs on Tableau's default ribbon. These are File, Data, Worksheet, Dashboard, Story, Analysis, Map, Format, Window, and Help. Let's quickly go through each of them. As with most programs, the File tab contains certain functionalities related to opening, closing, and saving files. If you would like to, you can also exit Tableau from here. But why would you want to do that? Data, on the other hand, is where you will find functionalities related to the data source you are using. Here, you can add a new data connection, replace an existing one, or simply edit the data source of the worksheet you are working with. Next, we have the Worksheet tab. It can be helpful when we want to create a new worksheet, hide or show a chart's title, caption, summary, and so on. I am sure you noticed that we already created a new sheet with the little icon we have at the bottom left corner of the sheet. And we can do the same thing from the Worksheet tab as well. Such repetition is common for most programs. Functionalities available in the ribbon can be accessed in other ways too. In fact, I rarely use the ribbon functionalities, but it is good to have an overview and be aware that they are there. Okay, next we have the Dashboard and Story tabs. As I said, we'll learn more about dashboards and stories later on in the course. The Analysis tab is where you can tweak your visualization in terms of labels, show figures as a percentage of the total, add trend lines, legends, filters, and more. We'll explore many of these options later in the course. For now, you can remember that here we have some interesting functionalities related to the way we perform our analysis and some of the tools we'll incorporate in it. Map is a tab that is helpful when we use Tableau's geographic visualization capabilities. Pretty soon you will see that this is one of the most powerful and impressive Tableau features. Of course, Format can help us adjust the way our visualization appears. From here, we can modify its font, font size, axis, backgrounds, labels, size, and so much more. That's another tab containing plenty of useful functionalities we'll explore later. Windows and Help are two of the standard tabs we find in most programs, so I am not going to spend much time on them. Also, because we are not going to use them throughout the course. However, one thing we should mention is that Tableau Public has a nice and open community of users who will be able to help you, and whose work you can look at if needed. All users of Tableau Public who save their work make it publicly available. Therefore, this can be a useful place where you can search for a given issue you need help with, and see what comes up. So, if I click on Community and search for Geography, I'll be able to see the work other users have saved previously. Right. This is Tableau's ribbon. Below the ribbon, we have several buttons that can be quite helpful. The Show Start Page button takes us to the screen we saw previously, when we connected Tableau and our GDP data Excel file. To get back to the sheet that was created earlier, I'll click here. I'm sure you know how to work with undo and redo. So if I were to drag one of the fields here, I can go back and undo this section with undo, of course. See? Undone. Most of the typical Windows shortcuts can be used here as well. As you probably know, the shortcut for undo is Ctrl-Z. On the right, we have other useful buttons, such as save, allowing you to save the progress of your work. Quite intuitively, new data source opens the connect functionality we saw earlier. The other buttons we have here are new worksheet, clear sheet, swap rows and columns, sort, and so on. We'll explore many of these throughout the course. For now, it would be best if you simply gain an idea how various objects are positioned within Tableau's interface. Okay, on the left side of Tableau's screen, we have two panes, Data and Analytics. The Data pane is quite important. It shows us what data we've loaded, and then Tableau classifies the data into two types. Dimensions, and measures. To put it slightly differently, this is a distinction between categorical and numerical data. The data in the dimensions field cannot be aggregated. It is qualitative in nature. Quite the opposite, measures can be aggregated and are quantitative in nature. In the next few lessons, we'll learn how to work with these fields. But for now, it would be nice if I just show you that we can drag dimensions and measures into the work area and use them to create our visualizations there. The work area is where we'll create our visualizations, dashboards, and stories. And this is one way to create a chart. I am sure you noticed that the columns and rows part of the sheet started showing us the variables we've added to the workspace area. We'll explore this part of the interface in a separate video in a few lessons. Okay, perfect. What else do we have? The Show Me button on the right, which allows us to adjust the type of visualization we use. It is a very cool feature because Tableau tells us what types of visualizations we can choose from, as not all charts will be available depending on the data we have chosen to work with. Once we decide we would like to switch to a different chart, all we need to do is select the respective type of chart, and Tableau makes the adjustment for us. Neat, right? And finally, here in the middle, we have three important sections: pages, filters, and marks. The Pages shelf lets you break a view into a series of pages, so you can better analyze how a specific field affects the rest of the data in a view. We'll use the Filters shelf when working with filters and filtering our data. The Marks shelf, on the other hand, contains functionalities related to coloring, size, labels, and so on. This lesson was a quick overview of Tableau's interface. I am sure now you have a better idea of what you see in front of you when you open the program. In the lessons to come, we'll continue to explore Tableau's functionalities, and you'll learn a ton about each of the buttons we mentioned here. As of now, this will do. Thanks for watching.